Good evening, everyone. Tonight is at 6 o'clock, or just about 6 o'clock, on October 22nd. This is the regularly scheduled meeting of the Sandwich Board of Appeals. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you. Bear with me, I have a cold. The Board of Appeals is comprised of 5 regular members and 1 alternate member. The Board of Appeals can have up to 4 alternate members. Any decision of this board requires a 2/3 vote. 2/3 of 5 is 4. If only 4 members vote, the vote would have to be unanimous. If 5 members vote, 1 member could dissent. This meeting is live and streamed on Sandwich Community Television's website and on local channel 9. The meeting is being recorded and will be available on the SCTV website at www.sandwichtv.org tomorrow. The board asks that if anyone is recording this meeting, please notify myself.
Taylor Frizzetti with the Sandwich Enterprise.
Thank you very much. All right, can I get a motion to approve the minutes of October 8th, 2024? All in favor? All right. The first item on the agenda this evening, and the only item on the agenda this evening, is old business number 24-15, Village Green Comprehensive Permit -NSG Village Green -1, LLC. Tonight we have Brendan Brides, the Building Commissioner, joining us, Amy Quessel, Town Council, her associate Jack Dowd, Judy Barrett, the 40B consultant, and her assistant Will Downey is also participating via Zoom. The permit is for the purpose of developing 144 units of affordable rental housing, including ancillary infrastructure building, a 4.8 megawatt energy system, a controlled environment agricultural building, wastewater and stormwater systems. This hearing remains open. It is not closed. And I'm gonna, this is going to be a little tedious, but we have a number of letters I need to read between parties here, just to put on the record. The first letter is from Jonathan Fitch to myself and the Board of Appeals. It said, "Dear Chair Nevin, on behalf of the applicant, I submit this protest regarding the failure of the Zoning Board of Appeals to adhere to the CMR procedures designed to ensure a fair and full review of my client's comprehensive permit application under Chapter 40B. The board's handling of the determination of local concerns and peer review process falls short of the guidelines set forth in both the applicable state regulations and the Massachusetts Housing Partnership, MHP, publications. Paragraph 1, failure to determine local concerns and adhere to peer review guidelines. After the application was filed on June 14, 2024, and the board promptly engaged Ms. Judy Barrett as a technical review consultant through Mass Housing Partnership, we expected a structured process to follow, including an initial review by Ms. Barrett prior to the hearing's commencement on July 9, 2024. Second point, the classification of components within the application and determination of which of them required specialized review beyond the capacity of municipal staff as recommended by MHP's Chapter 40B handbook. Point 3, coordination with other boards to build local capacity for reviewing the application as outlined in MHP's Chapter 40B technical review assistance. Despite the board's duty to engage in these steps, no comprehensive feedback was provided to the applicant except for a request regarding traffic. This lack of communication undermines the expected transparency and cooperation promised in the town's housing production plan and local comprehensive plan. Point number 2, improper peer review selection process. At the July 9th hearing, no meaningful discussion occurred regarding the scope of work or selection criteria for outside peer reviewers. Nevertheless, the board voted to hire peer review without consultation of any kind and the applicant. This abrupt action is inconsistent with the collaborative and open process mandated by both Chapter 40B and 760 CMR 56.05. 5 in parentheses. 2 days later, Attorney Quessel sent an email outlining significant deficiencies, but only procedural issues were raised. No substantive concerns relevant to the Chapter 40B were mentioned beyond traffic. There was no invitation to work cooperatively with respect to the peer review process. Instead, a peer reviewer was unilaterally selected by the board without input from the applicant, followed by a demand for payment of $29,780. Point number 3, violation of state regulations. The board's process blatantly disregarded state regulations, specifically 760 CMR 56.055 in parentheses, which mandates a fair procedure for selecting peer reviewers. Not only was the applicant excluded from the process, but the scope of work was never clearly outlined or discussed. The resulting no-bid contract and payment request are excessive, unreasonable, and procedurally flawed. Point number 4, unjust financial burden. The imposition of a $29,780 payment without prior discussion of the scope of work or the opportunity to solicit competitive bids places an undue financial burden on the applicant. This no-bid process contravenes the regulatory framework, which requires transparency and fairness whenever possible. Number 5, request for corrective action. We believe the board's conduct has violated 760 CMR 56 and MHP guidelines, frustrating the applicant's efforts to present and discuss its affordable housing proposal in full. We respectfully request that the board, number 1, rescind the current peer review contract, number 2, initiate a new selection process in compliance with 760 CMR 56.055 in parentheses, ensuring that the applicant has the opportunity to participate in identifying qualified consultants, negotiating a reasonable scope of work, and receiving the benefit of a competitive process. We appreciate your attention to this matter and look forward to action that restores fairness of this review process. Okay. Letter number 2 is also from Jonathan Fitch, addressed to myself as chairman of the board. This letter is in regard to objection to payment for peer review. Dear Chair Nevin, this letter serves as a formal objection to the town's request for NSG Village Green to remit $29,780 for peer review charges based on the Tetra Tech proposal accepted by the ZBA. After a thorough review, NSG Village Green declines to make this payment as the process leading to your demand is procedurally deficient and violates the requirements of Chapter 40B regulations. Specifically, we object to this demand on the following grounds. Number 1, the town has failed to identify any local concerns with the proposed development other than traffic. Without a comprehensive identification of such concerns, the basin for overly broad peer review is unfounded. Number 2, no determination has been made that any local concerns that may be identified cannot be addressed by qualified municipal staff. Peer review should not be sought unless municipal resources are demonstrably insufficient for proper evaluation. Number 3, the town has neglected to distinguish between general concerns applicable to any development proposal and those specific to Village Green, resulting in an unjustified and excessive scope of review. Number 4, there has been a complete lack of communication from the town to the applicant to define a mutually agreeable scope of work for any peer review. This failure violates the collaborative spirit required under 760 CMR 56.05. Number 5, the town has not adopted clear 40B regulations regarding the selection of outside consultants, which is procedural necessity. Until such regulations are in place and in compliance with Chapter 40B regulations, this process lacks the transparency and accountability required by law. Number 6, the Tetra Tech proposal was accepted through a non-competitive, no-bid process, raising significant concerns about the integrity and financial fairness of the review contract. Given these points, the applicant is compelled to assert that the town's approach was not only procedurally flawed, but also in direct conflict with the legal requirements set forth in 760 CMR 56.05A, B, and C. SIC. It is clear that the mandated process has not been followed, and therefore this request for payment is premature and unwarranted. We have previously communicated our concerns with Mr. Vitacco And although he and I have reached a mutual understanding on steps to address these deficiencies, the town has failed to act. As a result, we ask that the ZBA immediately withdraw this request for payment until the proper process is followed and a legitimate basis for peer review is established. Signed, Jonathan Fitch. Okay, those two letters were from Mr. Fitch. We asked Amy, our town council, to respond to these letters, and her response is as follows to Attorney Fitch. As of last Friday, the letters from Attorney Fitch were received, I believe, on Thursday last week. Dear Attorney Fitch, this is in response to your two letters dated October 8th, 2024, whereby you objected on behalf of your client, NSG Village Green, the applicant, to the Town of Sandwich Zoning Board of Appeals, the board, request for payment for peer review of the Village Green 40B development proposal, the project, and your protest of the board's comprehensive permit application review process. Excuse me. 760 CMR 56.055 in parentheses permits the board to require the applicant to pay a reasonable review fee in accordance with 760 CMR 56.05B for the employment of outside consultants chosen by the board alone, emphasis added. Further, if the applicant fails to pay the peer review fee within the stated time period, the board may deny the comprehensive permit based on this failure alone. 760 CMR 56.05, 5 in parentheses D, see also Zeno versus Carter, 21 LCR 383, 2013, in parentheses, permitting zoning board to deny relief based on applicant refusing to pay required outside consultant fee. Therefore, it is within the board's unilateral discretion to retain appropriate outside consultants where necessary, so long as the board does not impose unreasonable or unnecessary time or cost burdens on the applicant. 760 CMR 56.055. Your letter titled Objection to Payment for Peer Review questions the board's determination that the project contains sufficiently complex components requiring peer review. Pursuant to GLC 4453G, an applicant may only appeal the selection of an outside consultant on the grounds that the selected consultant has a conflict of interest or does not possess the minimum qualifications required. Footnote, such an appeal may be lodged with the town select board only within 20 days of the consultant's selection. 760 CMR 56.05E. Your objections to the board's selection of Tetra Tech peer review proposal, namely that the proposed review is overbroad, the project is not sufficiently complex to require peer review and was accepted through a non-competitive, no-bid process, are not grounds for appeal. To address your concerns, the board is not required to adhere to a competitive bidding process in hiring an outside consultant, nor is it required, quotes, to minimize a fee or accept the lowest possible proposal. See Wall Street Development versus Walpole Zoning Board of Appeals. Act number 2020-01, November 8th, 2021. The regulations give the board discretion in imposing peer review fees, provided that they are reasonable in light of the six factors provided in the 760 CMR 56.05 5C, see Wall Street Development Corp at 3C. The factors listed in 760 CMR 56.05 5C are: 1, the complexity of the proposed project as a whole; 2, the complexity of a particular technical issues; 3, the number of housing units proposed; 4, the size and character of the site; 5, the projected construction costs; 6, fees charged by similar consultants and scopes of work in the area. The project at hand, as you know, proposes to build 144 rental housing units, a wastewater treatment plant, a large-scale solar array, and an under-designated agricultural building on a project site totaling 33.36 acres of land. This large-scale project requires a review of the submitted plans. Footnote 2002, Oh, bear with me. Footnote. I note that to date, the applicant still, despite numerous requests, has not revealed an engineer of record. Further, the applicant has represented that Merrill Engineering, the firm that drafted the submitted plans, is no longer the engineer of record and is not associated with the project. I'll start that sentence over again. This large-scale project requires a review of the submitted plans. That was the footnote. Regarding utility designs, anticipator water supply needs, wastewater generation, traffic impact, and potential impacts to wetland and other environmental resources, among other concerns. In its opinion in Wall Street, the Housing Appeals Committee, excuse me, HAC, upheld the Zoning Board of Appeals' decision to obtain peer review consultation to review smaller and less complex projects or less complex changes to a project than what is proposed here, including the additional of 8 new rental units, an increase in lot size of 16,536 square feet, an increase in the number of buildings from 6 to 8, among other changes. See Wall Street Development at 3B. Given the magnitude of the project here, footnote 3, while other proposed projects did not require outside peer review, the size of this project, the location, and various proposed uses all require expertise from an outside peer reviewer. So given the magnitude of the project proposed here and the HAC's decision in Wall Street affirming a board's ability to unilaterally select an outside consultant, the board's decision to obtain peer review for the project and require full payment of $29,780 from the applicant is plainly within its rights and undoubtedly reasonable. I refer now to footnote 4. Tetra Tech, Inc. has reviewed numerous 40B projects and is without a doubt qualified, and its fees are reasonable. For example, 2023, Wayland, 60 age-restricted, 62-plus rental units in a single building on 9.2 acres. Proposed amount, $24,700. 2021, Pembroke, 414 1.5-story residential townhouses containing 56 condominium units on 48.9 acres, proposed amount $26,203. 2020, Walpole, 240 rental apartments and 60 single-family home ownership units, including 300 units, on 54.73 acres, proposed amount $41,858. 2019, North Reading, 200 rental apartments in 5 buildings, proposed amount $21,651. Further, the fact that the board would seek outside peer review and the subject matter of such peer review is no surprise. The board noted that it intends to use an outside peer reviewer starting at the first public meeting. Moreover, prior to the applications being filed, the town noted in its response to request for project eligibility letter, quotes, based on the criteria established in 760 CMR 56.055C, the town will be advising the Sandwich Board of Appeals that a review of the application will require technical advice in the areas of civil engineering, transportation, environmental resources, design review of buildings, and site. For these reasons, it is my opinion that the board's decision of an outside consultant was done pursuant to all applicable regulations and statutes, and the fee requested from the applicant is reasonable and required to be paid in order to further the comprehensive permit review process. The board has no choice but to suspend any further review of the project until peer review is paid in full, and if not paid, to deny the project for lack of information. Very truly yours, Amy Quessel. Footnote on that. It appears obvious that the applicant's refusal to pay the peer review is an attempt to circumvent the board and go straight to HAC, which, in my opinion, should not be tolerated, as both the state and regulations provide that it is the board, not HAC, that must review a 40B project in the first instance. All right, one more, everyone. This is a letter to myself again. The applicant came into the office yesterday morning with payment of the peer review in the amount of $30,000. Enclosed, please find a bank check in the amount of $30,000 as a deposit to cover potential peer review expenses associated with NSG Village Garden -1 LLC's NSG comprehensive permit filing. Under 760 CMR 56.05, Local zoning board of appeals are required to adopt rules for conducting their business, including matters related to Chapter 40B comprehensive permits. These rules must align with MGLC 40B 20-23, which is aimed to streamline permitting for affordable housing and reduce regulatory barriers. The absence of such rules in Sandwich has created confusion and inconsistency in the review process. NSG is not opposed to appropriate peer review by town staff or your selected expert. However, we respectfully request that the board adopt a balanced approach. Specifically, we suggest following Tetra Tech's guidance on tasks 1 through 6 and determining which tasks should be reviewed by Tetra Tech versus those that can be handled by town staff. Tetra Tech states in paragraph 2 of the proposal, quotes, each task identified below targets various areas where the ZBA may require technical assistance and provides an estimated budget to complete a technical review of materials expected to be submitted by the applicant. The work of each task is distinct from the other tasks, and the ZBA can choose which subject areas require our involvement. Rather than prolonged disagreements, we believe this collaborative and transparent approach will better align with the spirit of Chapter 40B and facilitate the creation of much-needed housing. We appreciate your consider and look forward to working together, signed by the applicant. Okay. Thank you for bearing with me. I'd like to acknowledge that the applicant did pay the bill yesterday, and I thank them for it, and we look forward to working with them on the project. We also, in the meantime, since the last meeting, we did receive public comments from a number of people. I just want to confirm that the board has received them and read them. Okay, now just one thing about tonight's process. We are not going to be taking any testimony from the applicant, nor will we be taking any public comment. We are down one member tonight, and we can't do either of those because of that. But also because it was just funded yesterday, and we really can't discuss anything further until the Tetra Tech has time to review the information submitted by the applicant. And I'm going to just turn it over to Amy for comment, and we'll go from there.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Amy Quessel, Town Council. Thank you for that explanation. There will be no testimony taken tonight. This is all purely procedural and scheduling tonight. There's three things that we need from the applicant tonight. We need an extension of the 180 days. The 180 days currently expires January 5th. We need to set a continuation date, which I think has been set for December 10th,
correct,
2024, which I think is will give Tetra Tech enough time to get into the plans and provide us with comments. I am going to check with Sean Reardon from Tetra Tech and make sure that that's enough time for him. And we do need an engineer of record. I was informed by Attorney Fitch earlier tonight that Merrill Engineering is the engineer of record, Deb Keller. So I will pass that on to Sean Reardon so he can submit his comments to her. And we do have a traffic report that was submitted from VHB. And it's been noted that the traffic report is not signed, and there's no indication of what staff member / engineer, whomever from VHB did the report. So we do need that information.
Okay. So to Mr. Fitch, you understand that we need an updated copy of that traffic report signed?
I understand each little thing you said.
Okay. All right. I'll make a motion to continue this meeting the next meeting on this special permit request to December 10th, 2024 at 6 p.m. at Old Sandwich here. Is the applicant willing to agree to the extension to February 10th? Okay. So I'll take a motion to continue this meeting to December 10th, 2024 at 6 o'clock at Old Sandwich Town Hall, Route 130. Here.
Second or make the motion?
And to allow for an extension of time until February 10th.
You made the motion, you need a second.
Right.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. All right, there is no new business, there is no board discussion, there is no deliberations, there is no other matters not reasonably anticipated. Someone want to make a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right. Thank you, gentlemen and ladies.